In today's video, we're going to learn about the structure and properties of two allotropes of carbon, diamond and graphite. And we'll consider the other allotropes, graphene and fullerenes, in the next video. First though, you might be wondering what an allotrope is. Basically, allotropes are different structural forms of the same element in the same physical state. So if we consider carbon in the solid state, it can take lots of different forms, like diamond, graphite, or fullerenes. So these are all different allotropes of carbon. Both diamond and graphite are giant covalent structures, which means that they're made of a regular lattice of covalently bonded atoms, which makes them both very strong. In diamond, each of the carbon atoms is covalently bonded to four other carbon atoms, which is the maximum number of bonds that carbon can make. This forms a regular 3D pattern, which you're fortunately not going to have to draw, but you do need to be able to recognize this sort of structure. As each of these covalent bonds is really strong, it will take loads of energy to break them. And so diamond itself is very strong and has a really high melting point. However, it doesn't conduct electricity because it has no free electrons or ions that can move around. Now, let's compare these features of diamond to those of graphite. First, each carbon in graphite is bonded to only three other carbon atoms, rather than four in the case of diamond. Second, the atoms are arranged into hexagons that together form large flat sheets, which are then arranged on top of one another to form lots of layers. However, these individual layers are only held together weakly, as there are no covalent bonds between them. This means that they're free to slide over one another, which makes graphite relatively soft when compared to diamond. That said, graphite still has a very high melting point, because the individual layers are strongly held together with covalent bonds. Now, remember how earlier we said that carbon atoms can make four covalent bonds each, but in graphite they only make three. Well, that means that each carbon atom in graphite has one spare electron that it's not using in bonding. Instead, this electron becomes delocalized, which basically means that it's free to move around. And all of these free electrons allow the graphite to conduct electricity and heat. Before we finish, it's worth mentioning that a single layer of graphite is known as graphene, and scientists can actually isolate these individual layers and use them to make other structures, such as spheres and tubes. We call these structures fullerenes, and we explore how they work in the next video. If you haven't heard yet, you can find all of our videos on our website, cognito.org. You'll also find questions, flashcards, exam-style questions, and past papers. And we track all of your progress so that you always know what to study next. So sign up for free by clicking here, or browse our playlist here on YouTube.